Okay, so this first example is pretty much the same thing as we already saw, right? Every thread is going to be reading from s of I minus 1 and then writing the result into s of I for its own value of I. And there's nothing in this statement to guarantee that all of these reads complete before any of these writes complete. And since they could be, you know, one thread's s of I sub 1 is another thread's s sub I, then there's absolutely the potential for a collision here. So the correct way to write this, as before, would be something like this, where we go ahead and insert a sync threads and a temporary variable to separate the read and the write. So what about this second example? Here, what this if statement does is it basically ensures that only the odd threads are going to try to read from s sub I sub 1 and write to s sub I. So if you think about this, thread 1 is going to be reading from location 0 and then writing to location 1. Thread 2 does nothing. Thread 3 reads from location 2 and writes to location 3. Thread 4 does nothing. Thread 5 reads from location 4 and writes to location 5, and so on. So in this case, there are no conflicts. So this code is actually correct, even without any additional internal sync threads. And our final example is, again, not correct. It's similar to the first one. Every thread is going to read from locations I minus 1, I, and I plus 1. It's going to do a little math, and it's going to store the result in location I. So clearly, to avoid, you know, to make sure that all of these reads happen before any of these writes, we're going to need a sync threads. So to make this code correct, we'd have to do something like this. We'd have to use a temporary variable, do all of the reads, sync, do the write, sync, and then do the printf. The writes have to complete before this printf is done to make sure that the printf prints the correct value.